Imagine if Earth had no moon but a twin, another Earth locked in a mutual orbit. Terra Ecliptide is such a world, where Titanic predators roam shores reshaped by each other's gravity, and behemoths stride through radiant deserts, their very DNA sculpted by the crucible of radiation and tides. Here, trees drift upon the ocean's surface, rising in waves, while serpents of the sky glide through the air. In this first episode of a two-part series, we journey through the wonders of a planet where life has adapted to an environment of stark contrasts and dynamic interplay between two celestial bodies. From the might of the tidal forces to the elusive eclipse dwellers, witness the resilience and diversity of nature on Terra Ecliptide. In the infancy of our solar system, a colossal event reshaped destiny. A celestial body, Theia, collided with the young Earth. Unlike the familiar tale leading to the Earth and Moon, this encounter forged a binary system of equal mass. The cataclysmic dance didn't just birth Terra Ecliptide and its twin, it sculpted their very essence with an uneven distribution of elements. Terra Ecliptide was bestowed with abundant water and nickel, but less iron, crafting a world unlike any other. This monumental collision also set the twin planets on an elliptical orbit around each other, mirroring the same axis as their orbit around the Sun. Notably, Terra Ecliptide emerged with a zero-degree tilt, a unique axial stance that further defines its climatic and environmental peculiarities. Circling each other in a dance defined by their closely matching initial spin, enhanced by their proximity and rapid orbital speed, they complete an orbit every 10 days. This unique synchronization over eons led Terra Ecliptide to become tidally locked with its celestial sibling, marking a fascinating chapter in the annals of cosmic phenomena. On one hemisphere, the dance with its twin planet brings about periodic solar eclipses, casting the world into darkness every day at the same time. This side of Terra Ecliptide experiences a rhythm of long 120-hour stretches of night, punctuated by a significant eclipse during periapsis, when the two planets draw closest. The event is not just a fleeting shadow, but a prolonged embrace, orchestrating an artificial night and cooling the planet's surface. Transitioning to the other hemisphere, the reality contrasts starkly. Here, the twin planet remains an unseen guardian, allowing day and night to cycle in relatively even measures. But it's during peak daylight that this hemisphere reveals its vulnerability. As Terra Ecliptide reaches apoapsis, the furthest point in its orbit from its twin, the planet's weaker magnetic field struggles to shield against intensified solar radiation. The absence of the neighboring planet's magnetic influence at this critical juncture leaves the surface exposed to a barrage of solar ions, challenging the resilience of life and land beneath the blazing sun. On the hemisphere of Terra Ecliptide that never glimpses its twin planet, giant behemoths stand as monumental testaments to adaptation and resilience, thriving amidst the extremes of radiation and searing temperatures. Additionally, these behemoths have evolved in an environment rich with uranium and saturated with radon, an atmosphere that accelerates mutation at a remarkable rate. Yet within this crucible of rapid change, they share a common lineage. Their vast differences in appearance, a testament to their species' capacity to embrace and thrive on genetic diversity. Solitude often defines their existence, with territories fiercely guarded and battles erupting on sight. However, when the need arises, they demonstrate an unexpected social flexibility, forming small herds to navigate the desert's perils together. Their size is no accident, but a necessary adaptation. In Terra Ecliptide's harsh ecosystem, where flash floods can sweep across the landscape without warning, their immense stature serves as a bulwark against the sudden deluge. These floods, though seemingly out of place in such arid expanses, are a recurring event, linked to the unique orbital dance of Terra Ecliptide and its celestial twin, Terra Veloxia. In the dance of Terra Ecliptide with its celestial twin, the gravitational forces at play sculpt a world where the might of the ocean is unleashed in rhythm with the cosmos. Every 240 hours, as the planets align in their closest approach, periapsis, the seas rise. rise in powerful crescendos, forging Titanic waves that crash with unparalleled force. Simultaneously, this celestial alignment dictates the ebb and flow of extreme high and low tides, transforming the landscape even far from the shores. Regions distant from the coast, such as the habitats of the giant behemoths, are periodically inundated by the surging tides, a testament to the potent tidal forces exerted by the binary planet system. In the boundless skies of Terra Ecliptide, evolution has taken flight in a spectacle of size and ingenuity, sculpting creatures that defy earthly constraints. The giant gliding serpent, with its expansive membrane wings, embodies grace and efficiency. These solar sails harness the sun's energy, warming their vast bodies and catching thermal updrafts to traverse the planet's skies without a single flap. Joining these majestic serpents are the colossal bats, creatures of stark contrast. The females adorned in white fur, while the males cloak themselves in the night. Their unique ability to navigate using the magnetic field of Terra Ecliptide's twin draws them across vast distances, guiding their migration to the hemisphere enriched by eclipses. Complementing this aerial dance, the sky jellies float with an ethereal grace. Adapted to Terra Ecliptide's unique conditions, they gather the abundant helium from the atmosphere to fill their bladders, achieving buoyancy. This ingenious adaptation allows them to float through the skies, their long trailing tentacles painting the air with elegance. In the dance of light and shadow on Terra Ecliptide, some creatures have mastered the art of survival under the veil of darkness and the prolonged shadows of periodic eclipses. Thriving in the extended nights and enduring the darkness cast by celestial alignments, they travel in large packs, a collective force moving through night and eclipse alike. Their keen senses pierce through the dim, finding life where light scarcely touches. Then there are these gravity-defying animals, leveraging Terra Ecliptide's reduced gravitational hold to bound across the landscape with grace. Each leap is a testament to the planet's reduced gravitational hold. Amidst the rugged terrain, creatures exploit the sanctuary of the land's fissures and cracks. Navigating the labyrinth of Terra Ecliptide's crust, their existence is a delicate balance of hiding and seeking, sheltered from the harsh elements and the eyes of predators. In the ever-shifting eclipse environment of Terra Ecliptide, a silent predator flourishes in the intermittent shadows and daylight. Its skin, a living canvas, mirrors the complex patterns and colors of the surroundings, becoming notably vibrant only when provoked or threatened. This adaptation, a sophisticated camouflage, renders it nearly invisible against the backdrop of the planet's varied terrain. It moves with a stealth born of necessity, each step calculated, each strike a culmination of patient waiting and precise timing. As Titanic waves herald their arrival, the tide ambushers emerge, poised between water and land. In Terra Ecliptide's rhythm of water's ebb and flow, they withstand crashing waves, ready to ensnare their prey in the tumult. In Terra Ecliptide's tempestuous seas, the wave-riding inlet fish display a mastery of the aquatic realm. Strong and flexible, they harness the power of the high tides, gliding atop the colossal waves to journey inland. Their elongated fins unfurl like sails. These soft coral colonies are a marvel of aquatic adaptation. Withstanding the force of tidal waves, these supple organisms bend gracefully with the water's ebb and flow. Their root-like systems, firmly anchored yet remarkably detachable, allow them to journey across the ocean floor. Within the oceans dwell these enigmatic beings. Their spiral forms, lined with delicate fins, coil and uncoil in a dance with the waves. These creatures harness the ocean's energy, rolling like living eddies, pulling sustenance from the swirling waters with each graceful revolution of their bodies. The sun-tracking umbrella plant is a marvel of adaptive botany, its expansive foliage unfurling in sync with the sun's arc. Even as eclipses cast their transient shadows, its auxiliary leaves capture the stray beams, ensuring a constant bask in the celestial glow, a solar devotion that fuels its life. Adrift in Terra Ecliptide's vast oceans, The nutrient-grabbing floater rides the rhythm of the tides. When the high waters of Apoapsis cast it ashore, it hastily anchors itself, siphoning Earth's nourishment. These brief terrestrial moments are as fleeting as they are vital, for the plant's survival hinges on the tide's capricious mercy. Gentle giants of the ocean, bobbing giant trees weather Terra Ecliptide's formidable waves. They bow gracefully under the aquatic onslaught, only to resiliently rebound. Their flotation-enabled trunks act as buoys, preserving life amidst the tempests, standing tall as sentinels of the sea. Join us on the next voyage of Imagine If, as we dive into the second episode of our enthralling two-part series. Journey with us to Terra Veloxia, a world where mountains reach for the stars and the ground pulses with the energy of a living planet. This episode unfolds a narrative where the sky blooms with auroras closer to the equator and ecosystems thrive in the shadow of towering volcanoes and within the depths of ionized forests. Discover the wonders of a planet where days are short and life has adapted in extraordinary ways. Don't miss this continuation of our cosmic journey. Subscribe and follow Imagine If for an unparalleled voyage to Terra Veloxia.